My mother often tells the story of how, when she was a young girl, her mother one day was very anxious and was looking out the window, and then she'd busy herself doing something, and then she'd go look out the window, and then she did this a couple of times, and my mother was very curious what was going on with Mama. And then a big truck came and pulled up to the house, and they brought in her piano. She and my grandfather, who was a supply officer for the Army Air Corps in San Diego. Not a lot of money, but it was a job with security. Even when they cut back after World War I, and the worst my grandfather had to settle for was to take a cut, and he lost his rank too. He'd been a captain, and then he became a warrant officer. But he still had a job. First, in the 1920s, it was okay. It was good to have a job, and he stayed with it because, he'd done it for years. He was already 40 when my mom was born. He'd been in the army since he was 15 or 16. According to the story, he lied about his age to get in. And he'd been to the war in the Philippines, and then he worked for the Philippine government after the war. And then, when the Great War broke out in 1914, he re-enlisted. And he ended up having to go to Texas in 1915 to work on the Pershing expedition that invaded Mexico, chasing Pancho Villa. And my grandfather was back in San Antonio, organizing supplies and sending supply columns to the south. Then he came out to Los Angeles with my grandmother, and my aunt had already been born. She was born in Kansas. My grandmother had to go to Kansas when the war heated up. Actually, it was the Mexican stuff that heated up first, and she went to Kansas, and my grandfather went to Texas. They had met in San Diego a couple years before and had gotten married, and then after the war, they came back to the West Coast, and they lived in LA for a year or two, and they're actually there on the 1920 census. They live in Los Angeles, and my grandfather was working still for the Army Air Corps, doing supplies. He was in I don't know what the base was in LA, but before my mother was born in September, they came back to San Diego, and they were renting a little place when my mom was born. And then when my mom was like one or two, they moved. One of my mother's earliest memories, she must have been about two, was when they went to see the house they were going to move to. And they moved there. And a year, 2 or 3 years later, not too long, because I think it was before my mom went to school, because she remembers all day her mother was looking out the window. And they had their piano delivered. And my grandmother played that piano for years. Then she gave it to my aunt, and when I was a child, my grandmother had an organ. Oh God, the refrigerator just turned on, humming away. My grandmother played an organ in the house, and I learned a little bit about playing organ from her small electric organ. Anyhow, I'm thinking of that time my mother telling me how her mother had been waiting for all day for the movers to bring the piano, because today I'm having, according to the UPS tracking website, I'm ha taking delivery of two boxes, one that weighs about 17 pounds and the other that weighs 26 pounds. And I'm very anxiously waiting and waiting. They say they'll be here from between 2 and 6 o'clock, or 2:45 and 6 o'clock, something like that. They say it's a 3-hour window, but I think it's really more like 4 hours. Oh, and I'm getting so anxious because they're bringing. I've been buying a lot of stuff online. I've spent almost $300 online the last few days on other people. I've got to buy. I don't have to buy Christmas presents, but I decided this year, instead of thinking about what trip can I go on, I'll buy Christmas presents for the rest of the family. Now, I have five brothers and sisters, and they're all married. No, I have four brothers and sisters. We are five children. And they're all married. And I've got my ex-wife and her husband, two people I'm very fond of, so they're on my list too. So basically, there's 10 people, brothers and sisters and their spouses, 10 people. And together among them, they have. 3, 4, 5, 6. We have seven children, and two of them are married, so that's nine. So there's 10 of the children and nine of the grandchildren, and then there's also two new babies, great grandchildren, my mother's great grandchildren. My stepfather's great-grandchildren. So there's like 20, and then there's a couple people around the edges. Of course, there's my mom. So there's like 25, and some cousins. So there's 30 people. If I'm going to buy presents for the close family members, I have to buy 30 presents. Now, I'm trying to keep it to $10, but some of them jump up to 20. Even so, I've already spent $300. Unfortunately, I've managed over the last 2 years to pay off most of the $3,000 debt I had from going to Paris 2 years ago. So my credit cards are back down kind of low, and I was starting to think about taking a big trip in the summer, and then I thought, no, I can't go. I can't go. I can't leave my mom for 2 weeks. One or two nights, maybe, but not for that long. They just, anyhow. So I've dropped almost $400 on Christmas presents. Just little things, $10 and $20. But of course, I had to buy a present for myself. Please, I'm selfish. I want a present too. So, I bought myself an Audio Technics turntable. It's a $300 turntable that I bought online on Black Friday, a week and 3 days ago, for $200. And because it was Black Friday, it was bundled with a $200 pair of powered speakers that I got for $20. Now they're regularly marked down to 150, 125, all over, but I got them for $20. So I got this $300 turntable and a $200 pair of powered speakers for $260. That's $500 of stereo equipment I got for $250. $250, $260, and it's being delivered today. Now, I'm not going to fix the turntable. I'm going to power up the powered speakers and their Bluetooth so I can use this laptop and all the music I've been downloading onto my little laptop. I can Bluetooth to the speakers if as long as I'm within 30 feet. So I'm getting all, because I want to have dinner with music. My mama wants to have classical music so much, and the classical music station here, it's so weak, and we're in a part of town you can't just get the signal right, and we've got a weak antenna. We can get it in the car, but we can't get it in the house because for some reason the old stereo, it's a good amplifier, but the tuner is weak. And I haven't figured out how to put up an antenna. If I did that, maybe it would get better reception. But as soon as I get the powered speakers, I can run classical music that I've downloaded from different storage sites. Lots of stuff I haven't really dared to use because it's kind of copyrighted, but you can play it, but you can't publish it. Oh, I hate it when I get an itchy throat. So I'm anxious. We're coming up on 12 minutes, and I'm going to stop this video. Goodbye, y'all, and God bless.